Okay, so my talk today is about non-profile deep learning-based side-channel attacks. And for the presentation today, I will use a Python notebook to run some demo during the talk. But so before we go to the demo, a bit of introduction and motivation. So in side-channel, we usually have, we divide attack into two categories. On one side, what we call non-profile attacks, when we only have one device available, which is closed, we cannot change the key, and usually we attack on the fly with method like CPA, for example. And then on the other side, we have profile attacks, where we have access to a profiling device, which is open, we can change the key, and so we use this device to characterize the leakage of the device during the attack. And so most of time, the profile attacks are performed using machine learning techniques, like, for example, support vector machine or template. And so recently, in recent years, we have seen that the trend in machine learning have been shifting toward deep learning. Today, deep learning demonstrates great performances for a lot of tasks, like a lot of machine learning tasks, like data classification, for example. And so following this trend in the trend in machine learning, we have seen that the side channel community has started to study the potential application of deep learning to side channel. We have seen several publications in the recent years. Most of these publications show a clear interest of using deep learning for side channel. Most of time, deep learning it outperforms previous attack techniques, and it has interest, for example, to attack mask implementations. One other advantage is that we can adapt the network architecture to the challenge or the implementation. So, for example, we can use it to we can use CNN to attack desynchronized traces. But most of this research so far has been mainly focused on the application of deep learning to profile side channel attacks. And the starting point of this research was to study how we could use deep learning in a non-profile setting. So, for example, when we don't have a profiling device. Because on the field, it's a limiting factor. We don't always have a profiling device. So this is the first thing I will present today is an attack presented in the paper. It's called differential deep learning analysis. It's a non-profile attack, so it's follow a strategy similar to other non-profile attacks, for example, like CPA. Very quickly, when we do a CPA, we have a device. We collect a CPA on AES, for example. We collect some data, some traces, corresponding to some non-plain text values. And then for each key guess, we will compute predictions. For example, the S-box output, apply a model, and for each key guess, we compute the correlation between the traces and the predictions. And this gives us information about the key. So for differential deep learning analysis, we follow a strategy similar to that. We collect some data. For each key guess, we will do predictions, apply a model. And the difference is instead of computing the correlation, for example, we fix the network architecture. And we will, for each key guess, train this network architecture with the traces being the training data and the prediction being the labels. And what happened is that for the good key guess, because the predictions are correct, we can expect that the training will have better metrics than for the other key guesses, because for the other key guesses, the predictions are not correct and so are not in line with the traces. So what does it mean better in this context? So there are several metrics we can look at. In the paper, there is several metrics we present. But the most straightforward thing we can do is simply to look at the classic metrics in deep learning, which are the loss and accuracy of the training. And this is the first thing I will demonstrate. I will do a first demonstration on this. So today, I will do the demo on my laptop. So I will use simulation traces. I will use traces of 50 samples. I will simulate the leakage of 1 byte of S-box, and this leakage will be located at t at the sample t equals 30. So this information is, this location is important for the rest of the talk for later on. So I will generate these simulation traces. For the demo, I will use a neural network, which is a MLP of 2 layers of 70 nodes and 50 nodes. And basically what I will do is I will run the attack I presented. I will run it on 3 guesses that we will observe the difference of metrics between the 3 guesses. So the 2 first guesses will be wrong guesses, and the last one will be the correct one. So if we observe, so we will observe the loss and accuracy of the training during the training. I will run each training on 30 epoch. So on the left you have the accuracy, on the right you have the loss, And so this is a training. This was a training for the first guess. Now we are training on the second guess. Both are wrong guesses. And on the last guess, we can observe that the metrics are clearly better because, as I said, the predictions are correct for the last one. So the training is better, and we can observe it on the metrics, and we can already determine which key guess is a good one. This was on three guesses, but actually, if you run it on, the, for example, 256 guesses, because we are attacking the S-box output, you will get something like this, where basically all the wrong guesses will tend towards the same metrics, while only the good one, the good key guess, will have better metrics, and we can distinguish the correct key value like this. So at this stage, we can already use deep learning to perform non-profile attacks. Later on, I will show you that we can actually leverage the advantages of deep learning, of profile deep learning, but in the, also in this context. But if we, at this stage, if we compare with CPA, for example, with CPA, when you do your when you compute your correlation, if you get a correlation peak, you have information about the leakage location. You know where the leakage is located. If you just look at the loss and accuracy, you don't have this information. That's why in the paper introduced some method based on sensitivity analysis to, during the attack, be able to locate the leakage area. So from a general point of view, sensitivity analysis is to study the sensitivity of a model with regard to some of its parameters. So in deep learning, a common application is, for example, to compute saliency maps, which tell you, for example, which pixel of the image contributes the most to the image classification. And so in the paper, there is some method with similar principle as saliency map, but in the context of side channel to locate leakage area. So there is different technique to do this kind of things like sensitivity analysis. In the paper, I mainly focused on method based on derivatives. And the first thing I will present it, in the next demo and in the paper, which is presented in the paper, is to look at the derivative with regard to the layers, especially the first layer of the network, because the first layer is connected directly to the input sample, so you can get direct information about the leakage on the first layer. So I will do a second demo, so I will keep the same neural network. It's an MLP, so the first layer is a linear layer, so you can represent it as a matrix of size number of input sample times number of hidden layers. It corresponds to these weights, the weight of the first layer. In Python, so in the notebook, you can represent it in three dimensions. For example, on the left here, you have the weights. So this axis corresponds to the input sample. This axis corresponds to the nodes. And the z-axis corresponds to the value of the weights. So this, on the left is the weights of the first layer at initialization. It's randomly distributed. Similarly, you can look during the training, you can look at the gradient of this layer. The derivative of the weights. Similarly, you can look at, you can represent it in three dimensions like this, with the same axis. And so we will observe that in the notebook. We'll run exactly the same attack as before on three guesses, but this time we will observe the gradient instead of the accuracy and loss. So on the first guess, it's a wrong guess. We will observe in average small gradient, and we don't observe any specific patterns. Now it's a training for the second guess. It's a wrong guess, so we observe something similar. When we do the training for the good guess, this time we observe something very specific. We observe big derivative values, and this big derivative all appear on the same line. You can observe on the same line, which actually correspond to 30, to t equals 30. So if you want to look at it on the diagram of the MLP, it actually corresponds to all these weights, which are all the weights are connected to the sample t equals 30. All these big derivatives correspond to these weights, and this sample is actually the sample which contains the leakage of the S-box. And so it's not something surprising, it's something we can expect, because so this sample actually contains the information important for the classification, and so in average it will have a bigger impact on the loss minimization. So you will, that's why we observe big derivative on this particular line. As it is here, you can already know where is the leakage. It's on t equals 30. If you want, you can, if you want a two-dimension representation, you can, for example, sum over this axis, over this axis. And you will get something, for example, like this, which is a bit more familiar in side channel. It looks like a correlation peak. Here I just summed over this axis, and we get something like this where we know where is the leakage. So here, what I present on the gradient, on the first layer, it mainly works with MLP. If you want to do direct application on CNN, it's not that easily. But so in the paper, there is a generalization, which is instead of looking at the derivative of the first layer, what you can do is you derivative with regard to the first layer, you take the derivative with regard to the, for example, to the input sample. Imagine, for example, you have a CNN here on the right with some input coming through the CNN. You can always compute the derivative of the loss, for example, with regard to the input sample. And similarly, the sample which contains the information related to the leakage, for example, they will produce big derivative in average, and you can spot that, you can accumulate this over the training and get information. So this one is a generalization, you can use it with any kind of network. What I presented so far in the presentation, so the differential deep learning analysis, the sensitivity analysis, what is interesting is that it works also on mask implementation. So if I continue the demonstration, but this time with simulated traces with where I put a mask, I add a Boolean mask, so I have a masked S-box, which is the leakage is still located at T equals 30. To do high order attack, we put a leakage of the mask this time at T equals 10. I will generate new data corresponding to this simulation. And if we run the same attack as before, we will observe that it also works with mask implementation. So again, we will look at the derivatives for the three guesses. So the two first guesses are wrong guesses. Again, we won't observe anything special on these guesses. In average, the gradient is small. So this one was the first guesses, now it's the second guesses. And for the good guess, we will again observe something very specific. So the good guess now is training. We can observe, this time we will observe again big derivative on two distinct locations, which are the line T equals 30 and the line T equals 10. So again, this time it corresponds to these weights. So it corresponds to the weight connected to the mask S-box leakage and corresponding to the sample corresponding to the mask. So we have big derivative here, and again, it's not very surprising. It's because they have a bigger impact on the loss minimization. So again, we can, if we want, we can sum over one axis after we accumulate it, for example, during the training. We get something like this, where we get information about the leakages. What is interesting is that, so it worked on mask implementation, but I didn't change anything compared to the first attack. I didn't adapt the attack to the second order, to this high order simulation. For example, if you compare with CPA, when you do a CPA, you will need to consider, for example, first if it's a mask implementation, how many shares, maybe you will need to apply some pre-processing to prepare your data before you attack. Here, we didn't do anything like that. We applied the same attack it was the same attack between unprotected and protected. I didn't do any pre-processing. Actually, it's the network itself, it's a network which adapts itself to the situation, and it can attack both protected or non-protected implementation. So it's especially interesting, for example, when you are in black box, maybe you don't have information if it's a mask implementation or how many masks are used, because it's also, with sensitivity analysis, it can reveal leakage area. So it's interesting, for example, if you are in black box, this kind of analysis can help to maybe reveal information about the key, but also about if there is mask and where these masks are located. So here today, I presented I did the demonstration on simulated data, but in the paper, so there is several results of this type of attacks on real target. So we have some results on attacks on the chip whisperer light with mask implementation using one, but also two masks. It's also work. We went until three shares, and. Also result on ASCAD, which is a public data set. Here you can see the result on ASCAD. So if we look at the accuracy metric on the left, it reveals the correct key value. If we look at the sensitivity analysis, it reveals two distinct areas that if you look at it with other methods, you can notice it corresponds to the area of the mask where the mask is manipulated and the location where the mask S-box is located. Today I decided to mainly focus on mask implementation is one of the interests of the attack. But in the paper, there is a bit more. Actually, what is important to understand is that with this method, we are able to use deep learning in non-profile. So we can basically leverage all the advantage of deep learning in a non-profile context. So one interest is mask implementation, but another interest is, for example, you can use CNN to attack desynchronized traces. We have in the paper there is result on desynchronized traces using a CNN. We can do a non-profile attack, and it compensates the effect of the desynchronization. It's another interest. To conclude, so in the paper there is two main contributions. The first one is introduction of differential deep learning analysis to do a non-profile attack with deep learning and neural networks. We are able to leverage the power and the advantage of deep learning when we are in a non-profile scenario. As I said, we can attack both protected and non-protected implementation with the same attack process. And it works also with CNN, again, desynchronized traces. What I forgot to say is that the sensitivity analysis also work with CNN on desynchronized traces. Even if the traces are desynchronized, we are able to see where is the leakage. The second contribution is the introduction of sensitivity analysis to apply to side channel to locate leakage area in the trace. So we are able to reveal intermediate values, leakages, mask leakages. We are able to do it on any neural network architecture if you consider the derivative with regard to the input samples. And last remark is that in the paper and during the talk, I talk about sensitivity analysis in the context of non-profile attacks, but actually these kind of techniques also work in for profile deep learning attacks. If you are doing profile trainings, you can also use sensitivity analysis to locate leakage area. So yeah, that's it for me today. Thank you for listening.
Thank you, Benjamin. That was nice. The demo was very impressive.
Thank you.
Is there any question for Benjamin?
Hi. Thank you for the nice talk. If I remember correctly, you used MLP networks for all the masking case studies and CNN networks for all the misaligned case studies. Can you use CNNs also for the masking case studies? Because I'm asking that as we try to reproduce some of that results and we notice that the CNNs are really bad at learning higher order leakage. Doesn't matter if univariate or bivariate.
Yeah, so that's correct actually. On the paper, the masking experiment are done on MLP and CNN for desynchronized traces. What I found is that it's easier to attack masked implementation with MLP. And but I'm not sure if we, I think we should be able to break mask implementation with CNN, but I haven't really dig into that. Yes.
So you don't know of any reason why CNNs are incapable of learning that?
My guess, I don't have strong result or evidence, but my guess is that because CNN is sliding on the first sample, for example, while MLP is combining the value of the different sample, I guess it's maybe easier for MLP to find quickly good combination of the way to combine the mask and the, for example, mask S-box. But it's something I haven't studied deeply, actually.
Yeah.
No problem.
We have only time for one quick question. Is it quick?
Hopefully. Very short question. Thanks for the nice talk. I was just curious if you had the chance to look in terms of computation time, like compared to, for example, a higher order CPA or doing a PCA with a CPA.
So
at what order does it start to get interesting to use this one?
So yes, the computation time is one of the drawbacks of the attack because you need to perform one training for each key guess. So we didn't compare with CPA or second order CPA, for sure second order CPA will be faster because with the deep learning you need to train several epochs before you get information. In any case, CPA will be faster, I guess.
Let's thank Benjamin again.